Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. If you guys have a Jeep Cherokee, Jeep Renegade or Jeep Compass, guys, and you're trying to replace the brake vacuum pump, or also known as vacuum pump, on your 2.4 engine, guys, stay with us. We'll demonstrate how to do that. That engine is used in all these Jeeps, plus it's used in multiple Dodge and Chrysler vehicles as well. Now, as you can see, guys, the engine is out of the car. You do not have to remove your engine. Why we got it out? Because we'll guys have at least 100 videos on that engine alone. We'll be taking the whole engine apart, guys. We'll show you how to fix almost anything. In addition, every car we get at the shop, we'll be making at least 200 videos, because our goal is to save you guys as much money as we can. So please, guys, subscribe to the channel and like the video, guys, for all the work we do, and hopefully we can save you some money. So let's go ahead, start on it, and show you what you need to do to replace the brake vacuum pump now on that 2.4 multi-air engine. So we're going to go ahead, move the engine, okay, a little bit this way, and now, guys, we can show with a great detail where everything is located. First, as you can see, guys, okay, you have that engine cover that we will need to remove. That engine cover, usually, okay, if it's installed, okay, let me push it all the way in, okay, when it's installed, grab it, okay, and pull it. It has, guys, four rubber bushings. Let me explain. Four rubber bushings that we need to remove by pulling. 1, 2, 3, 4, guys. And they attach to these points of the engine. One here, here. Okay, we have there and there as well. So, what else we need to do now? Facing the engine, guys, this is your exhaust manifold right here. Next to the exhaust manifold, this is on the exhaust camshaft. This is your brake vacuum pump. You have a brake line. This is the brake line that goes to the brake booster. And this is, guys, the pump right here. And we'll explain what needs to be done now to get that thing out, and if you need to replace it. All the tools and parts, guys, including if you need to buy a new pump, we'll have the link in the description of the video below for your convenience. So please check it out. Now, first, we need to disconnect that hose, guys. Okay, that hose. You can see these two things. You need to spread them gently. Don't break them. And you have two more on the back side. Now, you can go ahead, okay, and pull it out. After that, guys, we have only three bolts that hold the pump in place. So we'll go ahead, remove those. Okay, so we have 13 millimeter socket. One, then two and three. You may leak some oil out, guys. Why? Because it's part of the camshaft, it's attached to the camshaft. There is two O-rings. Okay, I'm going to explain that in just a second. Okay, and after that, if we grab it, gently pull it out. Where the O-rings are, one is right here, guys. You can see that big O-ring. One little O-ring, okay, over there. So those will need to be replaced, or if you buy a new one, make sure that it comes with those. Why you may leak oil out, because you can see this is, guys, okay, right there, your camshaft. Okay, that's the exhaust camshaft, and there is oil there. So that's how you guys remove it. Installation practically is in reverse order. We took it apart. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to the channel, guys, for more videos. Hopefully the video will be helpful, and see you guys next time.